In this episode of Fenobric Machining, we are going to talk about safety in the workshop, and especially and probably only about the safety with your lathe. Lathe is a very common tool in a workshop, and it can be really dangerous. They are usually very powerful, they are fast, and they have features that make them really dangerous. Let's start with the general setup. Okay, so here I am having a totally inappropriate clothing to operate a lathe. Well, the first thing is that I have these sleeves which are dangling around. Okay, I will demonstrate why these are really dangerous. And then I have this thing that is flapping here near my big belly. Of course, this is really comfortable, but nevertheless, this is not the clothing you should have here. So let's take it off and start to demonstrate what can happen in your lathe. Ah, wow. Okay, a little bit of belly there. Okay, so this, never use something that is so loose. Even if you wind up the sleeves, it's still loose. Okay. That's the first step. And another thing that is wrong in this picture is that I'm not wearing any safety goggles. Your sight is probably your most precious thing. You cannot cope. If you become blind, you forget about the lathe. Kind of eye protection could be used. I have here these. They look cool, but these are not really protective glasses, so no. Then I have these. These are more like that, but these are not very. These are not made from proper material. They shatter, and these are only intended for one-time use with fireworks. There is my bin. I don't know why I have been saving those. They are just taking up precious space here. Then these are more proper. These have good quality material in them. They are like that, and they cover up your eyes quite good, quite well. And but they are still there is still they are have a color. This one is these are intended to be used with blue lasers, so that you don't damage your eyes with a laser. But nevertheless, they are really cool. Maybe these. Well, the best solution is it's a very similar looking thing. This time no color, and these are light. These have been made out of proper material, and they protect your eyes. And then the optimizer, this one. This does not protect your eyes. Never think that when you wear these you are protected. No, you should always have these under and then use these above. This is because the material here is not. These are made of polycarbonate. This is from something else. I believe it's plexiglass or something. It will chatter. Furthermore, there is a big gap under here where the chips can enter your eyes quite easily. As a matter of fact, these collect something. They like guide the chips into your eyes. So these always And then if you want to, I need these, so I always have these and then these on top of that. Okay, so, well, now that we are quite properly clothed, we are wearing the stuff, sometimes you want to protect your hands. Rotating things and gloves, not a good combination. These are welding gloves, and there is a thing that they can grip into something there, and they don't just come off like that. They take your fingers with them, and then you collect your fingers from inside your glove. Never wear this type of gloves with Lathe. If you want to protect your hands, one thing that you can do is to put hand cream on your hands in advance. Not after, of course after washing your hands, but in advance. That will actually soak into your skin and then the oil doesn't penetrate that well into your skin. And then you can use these nitrile gloves. These are these rip off before they take your hand with them. Of course, there are really heavy duty nitrile gloves, which really can take your hand with them. But these are if you want to protect your hands like this. I rarely have had an occasion when I need to have that type of gloves. Okay, so looks like we are ready to go. I don't use any gloves today. The first thing we are going, I try to demonstrate is just a round object spinning in your lathe with probably in the safest chuck you can have, which is the collet chuck. So, the first rule of thumb in a lathe is that if it rotates, don't touch it. And if you have those dangling clothes on you, let this present a dangling cloth, it's dangling. It's a piece of my old t-shirt. And let's see, this one here, well, let me zoom you in so you can see better. So, this is just a 16 millimeter rod, cold rolled steel, which I have put into a collet here. And I turned it really smooth on top. The best I could. I didn't want to grind it or have a bare time treatment or anything. The finish is quite good. So let's see what happens if I do this. So, it really doesn't want to grip. No, it does not. Okay. But you never know. Let's put something sticky in it. This is some rockhole paste. There might be some cutting oil leftovers on your shaft, etc. You probably already know what happens next. So there could be a tiny layer of this. Maybe you wanted to put the rockhole there in advance to do some threads or anything, and then you left it rotating like that. So let's see now what happens. If you put this bolt there, this is a dangling sleeve, and when you put it there, it immediately grips. And even if it is really smooth, it can be dangerous. And Let's see what happens if we raise the speed. You think that that was so slow that you could probably notice it in time, and then what do you think that happens now? Let's see. Well, it doesn't want to grip anymore. Let's put some more stuff to it. Wipe off the stuff. Well, okay, there you are. Now, and I have to be really careful with this one because it when it grips, it really grips. And the lateral reflex is to be hold on that one. Therefore, I had my hand here, so I couldn't follow it. Yeah. But if you are doing it like here, or you are trying to wipe it off clean, for example, with a rag like this, always do it while your lathe is in standstill. Never touch a rotating object. Okay, this was a really fine finish, but let's do a worse, a really bad finish and see what happens then. Now, here is your bad finish. I had this insert which is really broken. Well, it's badly broken, so it didn't cut well, but it produced exactly what I wanted. That is like a file. And you probably would like to sandpaper that one. But now this demonstration. So, how much do you think that I need to show this to this bad finish when it grips? Let's see. Not a lot. It only takes one corner from this. Only one tiny corner like this. And it already grips it along. So, and so the sleeve doesn't need to be loose, just like this, and it already grips. I can feel how this really wants to come along. So, loose clothing with rotating objects in a lathe, no, no, and no. So, with your hands, you may be, you are not safe to touch this kind of thing even with your bare hands, because it will file your hands or cut your hands quite easy. Okay, so that's number one. No loose clothing, no touching rotating things. And let me show you more rotating things in the lathe. So, what we have rotating in here, you can see here is one thing that is rotating. This is the feed shaft. You should not touch this one. And for this reason, you shouldn't have a flapping thing under you. You should not either lean on your lathe like this. No, that's no as well, because you could slip. And then you are done. So please stand, and yeah, that's about. And now we change chucks. This is now a collet chuck, which is quite secure. You can run it in really high speeds. It tolerates everything this machine can give, and this is actually almost 4000 RPM, and well, it's not a lot if you think about today's CNC machines, but it's still enough for me. And okay, so let me change the chuck for a three jaw chuck, which is our next patient here, which is one step less secure. Okay, this is now the first time you can do some real damage to your machine. So, First of all, the compound is, well, you can run it into the chuck. Well, sometimes this happens even if you are careful. And the only way you can avoid this from happening is to test for clearances. In this case, we have some clearance here, so you can rotate this free. But if I now turn this a little bit nearer like that, then it will collide. Not now, but if I put a little bit nearer, so clunk it is. And on the lathes that come from like schools, you have this corner of the compounds always, it has some picker marks in it. This one as well, although it didn't come from a school, I know. But yeah, this is the corner that gets violated most often. Well, that's one thing about three-jaw chucks. Of course, all that has been said from this workpiece, how it grabs you, that's valid with a three-jaw chuck as well. But then we have one, why I should use three-jaw chuck is a certain type of stock. And now I will demonstrate you something. That you probably didn't know, or maybe you knew, but usually when you have this type of hex stock, you are using three-jaw chuck to chuck it. Yeah, okay. So first, the correct way of putting this into chuck is to rotate it like this, clingety clangety, and then until it stops rotating. Then you tighten it, and it will be there. It's tight and secure. But let's see now. If this rotates this way, this tries to rotate that way. Okay, let's now tighten it a little bit like that. Okay, there you are. I don't start this lathe because this is dangerous. So now it looks like it is there. Securely, right? So let's put some cutting forces into it. This is our cutting force. So you have, because it's rotating now this way, so we have, let's put the back gear on. So we have the cutting forces trying to tighten it that way, okay? So let's see what happens if I apply some cutting forces to that. Oh, it didn't take much. And loose it goes. And I really tightened it. Let's do this again. And believe me, this is a mistake that you make really easily. You just put your stock into there and then you tighten it like that. And then I did tighten it, and then you apply some cutting forces like that, and it comes off. So one more time, hex stock in a three-jaw chuck, always wiggle it like this. And then tighten it. And then you can apply whatever force is there, and it doesn't come off. It still stays there. So, careful with the hex stock in a three-jaw chuck. There is also another difference between the three-jaw chuck and the collet. The collet has its so-called chuck key, the mechanism for tightening it. It is permanently on the backside of the lathe. So, well, the only thing is that you forget to tighten it and then you get a little bit rumble and nothing bad happens then. But these have a chuck key like that. Oh, yeah. Well, I feel bad when I leave it like that in there. That's a habit that I have, well, I have learned it. Well, with my first lathe, I once forgot it there. And, well, it became a projectile and shattered my window here. And, well, that's a new window. yeah. So, never ever leave it there. Even if the lathe is not powered, just learn the habit of taking the chuck key along. Yeah, that's one. And then you also have one feature in this one, it has its limits. At some point the engagement into the spiral there becomes so only so little that they are not securely there. This is probably the largest object I can chuck in here, but I think it's already, and please notice, I wiggled this one as well when I put it there. This is pushing the limits, actually. So, well, and then when you have these jaws extending like this, you have the greater danger of damaging your compound here. So always check the clearances by rotating this. You put it to the extreme travel and it barely misses. But clearance is clearance, even if it is one hundredth of a millimeter. It's a clearance. But if you put it like this, it will, yeah, you can hear it, so that's one. So clearances can become an issue with this one. Furthermore, when you have your tool here secured in place, with the multifix, don't leave this here. It can drop off and go anywhere. It's a loose thing. You don't need, you want to have any loose things on your lathe while you are turning. Well, and this one is now the bad insert. I changed here a bad insert to get that bad finish. So, now, if you want to change this, and this, let's turn this on a little bit slow speed. So, when you turn it like this, and you want to change this, don't change it while it's running. Always stop the lathe, then change the tool. Always. That's a mistake I have been doing recently. For some reason I forgot what had happened to me. Let's assume that you are here. Let's turn this again off. I don't want to do this. So, please turn off. Turn off. Huh? Yeah? Yeah. So, what can happen when you pick it up? You drop it somewhere there, and then you have it go into there, and it will damage not only your workpiece, it probably will damage your chuck and the vase, and what more. So never ever change your tool while the thing is rotating. And then now we would like to get rid of that horrific finish in this thing. And what's better than file it away from there? Okay. Filing in a lathe Oh well, this is not a file you are going to use in a lathe. There is no handle. And when you file with this in your lathe, it could, for example, go into that, and then it will bounce back, and then you have it permanently attached to your hand. Although it might be convenient to have a file permanently attached to your hand, it's very painful. And, well, you can lose your hand as well. Therefore, always ensure that your files have a handle. And then, before you start even thinking about filing here, clear the environment. For example, this one has this tool now here. It has a sharp tip. And when you are filing, you could injure yourself into that sharp tip, really. So the only way to ensure that you don't have that sharp tip available is to remove the tool. And then you should clear, have enough room all over the place. Not like trying to file it somewhere here or there or anything. Just make it clear. And then, what you do, what I do, I always rest my other hand here so that it's safe. And then, and then you see what's the result. Because you have a sharp corner here, really, really sharp, you could it could lacerate you quite easily. So, well, and filing is really, now it isn't so hairy, so to say. And, it's not good, file is a very good tool in a lathe, but you have to be careful with it. Always ensure that you have room around to operate it. So now we don't have that sharp corner there either. So that's a thing with treat or chuck and operating it in a lathe safely. Don't forget the key in here when attaching any object, actually, but especially when attaching the hex stock, wiggle it. I have learned the habit to wiggle every object I attach to this one. Namely, if it's not perfectly round, it could be so that you succeed in attaching it in a way that it loosens when you apply the torque to it. Okay, now that we have filed this suitably, of course we want a little bit better finish than just file. So what we do, we can use abrasives, sandpaper, emery paper, if you want. And, there is a problem. Now, how do you hold... you can have a so small piece of paper that it cannot grab you. It's so small that it doesn't reach... around this thing. So then it's probably safe to grind with this one. But if that paper is so long, and you grind it, for example, like this, it can go around like this into there. like that. It goes around, and after that it will grip, and then you have your finger there, and eventually the whole hand. And it won't let go. So the safe way to hold this is to hold it like this, along paper. Soft papers you can hold like near the object, if you trust the surface so that it isn't bad. One thing more, the emery, this is too big actually. I should cut it at least in half, maybe in three. And then you can, this one is not so dangerous, but it still has a capability of damaging you. What I'm using usually are these. These are from my rotating grinder, this epicentric, whatever that thing is, and there is a mosquito. And then you just, because these are quite stiff, you can place it like that there. Okay. So, one thing. This is not a safety thing, this is more like taking care of your lathe. Cover your base when you start doing grinding here. Not a bad practice if you use abrasives, because now they drop here and don't collect anywhere in the base. And of course you should clean your ways afterwards. So let's see, let's try, this is something like 60, grade 60. So let's see, so I do it like this. And no, I'm only holding it with my fingers and I don't let it go. You can also do it like this. Be very careful here. This could bite you. Okay. That's pretty rough, I would say. And then with this one, I do it from the outside here. The wrong way with this one is to do it like this. This is bad. So, to avoid injuries, just on the top. This is, well, this way it doesn't wrap around the workpiece. And this is really, really rough. You can feel how rough it is. It's, oh man! Well, it's starting to get finished. And then you can finish this with this one. And again, I don't wrap it around because it could grab my finger. Okay. It takes a little bit longer time and you will have to push a little bit harder here. But yeah, okay. So, the unsafe way is this type of grips. These are really unsafe. Hopefully you can see what is unsafe here. And so, with a long paper, hold it from the ends. The reason for this is to hold it like this, is that if you hold it like this, the human reflexes make it so that when it grips, you grip harder. And this reflex is really hard to overdo. You cannot learn away from it. It's a natural reflex which is coming from the, from your spine. It never reaches your consciousness. You cannot learn away from that. So, that reflex. It's really a reflex. And therefore you should keep it like that. And after you have done your grinding, just take away your clothes. And maybe you can also do some cleaning here, although this is not necessary after you have had a nothing came off from that. So that's sandpaper and lathe. Those are there is one really unsafe way, and then a few which are really safe to do. So now, next thing which I would go briefly through here is about the chips. Unfortunately, I only have chips here in my chip pan, like these. Hopefully you can see what kind of chips these are. So if you have chips here, let's assume you have been turning something and then you have find it having chips like this. So if they are there like that, don't go with your bare fingers and try to grip them away. In half of the occasions it succeeds, and if it grips there, you will lacerate yourself. So the correct solution, even these are not the correct ones, I could show you. Well, if I can, well, I cannot take these now apart, but the best, you can use pliers. Use small pliers for this one. So you just grip it with pliers and take it away from there. This way you are not dealing with the sharp chips which might lacerate you. And furthermore, this is safest to do when the lathe is standing. You could also, I actually could now make these. No, I cannot. Well, okay. The thing is that the handles of these should be really slippery. These are somewhat slippery. These have a foam, but this is quite hard, and it's slippery. The reason why it should be slippery, these, is that when it grabs somewhere like that, it won't draw your hand there, but these go away from your hand. Having something like this, for example, which have a good grip, where your hand is gripping good well, then there is a great chance that your hand follows your pliers. So, but this one I know, they slip out of your hands, and it's a good thing to happen. So chips, if they are like that, those stringy ones, and we have here some yarn. I think we succeeded in collecting yarn into our feed shaft. So yeah, if you are taking your chips, use pliers, because the chips can be razor sharp. Okay, that's just shortly about the chips. Well, this was operating a lathe in a safe way. Well, I'm pretty sure I didn't cover all the issues there are. Some are really setup dependent, for example, strange objects which are eccentric and put in a lathe. Furthermore, I didn't want to show what can happen if you try to cut too thick chips. These might damage your tools, etc. And so on. But when you operate the lathe, always, if in doubt, stop and think. It might save your day and save your ass in the best case. So one shouldn't become cocky with the lathe. It will bite you any day, and the bites are not really nice. And one thing worth mentioning here, because mostly we are working in our hobby shops alone. This means that if you encounter an accident, so you are alone. That's a really bad situation. You should avoid that situation at all cost. So better work slowly, better not rush with things. Just take your time, think, and be safe. Well, okay, enough babble. This is supposed to be fun, and not like a safety issue. It's not a beast, it's a tool. It doesn't have brains, so as somebody said, it doesn't have brains, so you better use your own. Okay, in the next episode of Fenogreek Machining, we are going, maybe, yes, we are going to go into the nice world of stepper motors. And we are going to make a controller for that stepper motor. Yes, I already have a controller, but we have to make a pulse generator for that one. And that's in the next episode of Fenogreek Machining. Till then, see you!